lifetimes ago, stepped through that door.
What is in there?
Oh, I'm not here to spoil that for you. Only to help you prepare.
Why?
Because I can. Because for us, fighting occupies the body, while our minds work out the rest. Because... you're not ready. Yet.
Show me.
Who shot it? Why exactly are you attacking us?
Consider it a kind of trial by combat, Ramir. When Kratos can get the better of me, we'll know whose mind has done the work. Your strength lives up to reputation. Valor should go the distance, I hope. Arms up. Places a deficit upon his focus. He is impatient, emotional, easily surprised. A man at one with himself has a clearer mind, sharper instincts. That man is ready to win. That man is ready to progress.
Come up, you brother! An improvement over last time. Don't lose heart, brother.
Kratos.
Fresh rewards with a side of new opportunities.
Kratos.
Who wouldn't want to buy a slightly more hospitable environment?
Much better than last time. It seems you're...
Sigrun, it's good to see you back.
Freya was just being cautious. I'm right as rain. How fares your journey?
We have uncovered our host. It is Tyr.
Tyr, you say?
Aye. And no projection either.
I never knew his connection to Valhalla was so strong. But then, he goes back further than I do. Fascinating.
Before you ask, yes, I was back in my old forest again. And this time I encountered my former boss, King Oberon. Rather eye-opening, actually. I used to be a true believer for him. Would have done anything he asked. But now I see through all that charisma and feigned wisdom down to the small, hypocritical tyrant I know him to be. Wait till I tell you what he put me up to regarding a particular magical flower.
Huh.
One left.
First master.
Aye. Seems to be the very story Valhalla has me reliving, in fact. Oberon fancied himself a romantic, you see. Always claimed that love was more important to him than anything. One time, he led his entire entourage on a journey to attend the wedding of some duke or other, near your old neck of the woods. The groom, this lordly prick, had conquered a warrior queen and was marrying her as part of terms for peace. And this, somehow, was so romantic to Oberon that he dragged us across the sea to pay respects. Never mind, he was quarreling with his own queen the entire way! Well, I'll have more of that one, to be sure. Even a short-term advantage could pay off. I was saying about my old master and his lofty so-called romantic ideals. We settled in a forest outside of Athens, a place well situated to observing the comings and goings of the Duke's other guests. There we observe the romantic complications of some local use, and Oberon gets it into his head to intervene, bids me fetch him a magical flower that can manipulate the affections of others. Supposedly, the idea was to nobly help Hela prevail over the pressure of family arrangements. But what he really wanted was to use the flower to torment his own wife.
I see why you left his service.
Aye. Hmm.
behind you!
Incoming!
Clear now, whenever you're ready. We've come this far. Anything we need this moment.
Oh!
another. At least you fell to one of the more challenging opponents. No shame there.
Greetings.
Great progress, but always more to be done.
Sir.
A chance to bargain with Valhalla itself. That benefit's good to last.
Don't let Valhalla's chosen opponents get into your head, or else you'll fall to them again.
Sigrun, love, what's the latest on Midgard?
Life returns at last.
I
would know it.
Glad to hear.
And now that...
While I'd love to say I left Oberon's service as a matter of principle, the truth is, it was much more a question of pride. If he'd simply shown me more appreciation, who knows how long I might have tolerated his evils. I certainly tolerated plenty from my subsequent employers before I could take no more. If I'm being honest, I was only too happy to offer my complicity in Queen Titania's humiliation.
What did you do?
Caused her to fall in love with something preposterous. An act.
tough.
Master, he had you make his wife fall in love with another.
Aye, temporarily, by use of this magic flower. Though now it's clear to me the flower's effect isn't love, exactly, but a kind of obsessive devotion that is too often mistaken for love. So, of course, the queen made a fool of herself, as did all those under the flower's spell that night. I don't know how I ever got embroiled in such a farce.
You are wiser now.
I think so. Though that only makes up for so much past stupidity. Hard not to take Valhalla up on some help, even if it's just for this attempt.
Hmm.
On the battlefield there. Then the path should be unlocked. Let's make our way up.
Oh, be back.